When Reading visited West Brom in September, they were still looking for their first league win. And at the end of the game, the teams couldn't have been further apart. West Brom went top. Reading found themselves languishing at the foot. Victory did follow at home to Oxford, but then enter Messrs Morrissey, Kelly, Jones, Thompson and Jones, and 6-0 later, a humiliated Reading limped home from Prenton Park. But then the club's record £800,000 signing from Brentford came good. Carla Saba cut Sunderland to ribbons as the Royals roared back to form. Elm Park then welcomed Nottingham Forest for one of the games of the season. Reading were 2-0 down when Dave Besant ran into trouble. Martin Williams then put Reading back into the game. Only for Forest to restore their two-goal lead on 66 minutes thanks to a fierce strike from Kevin Campbell. But the game was far from over.
Here's Lambert. Reading could make a breakthrough. There may still be a match in this. And this is great work from Lambert. What a brilliant goal!
I told you when you come down, anything can happen, Danny. At 2-0 we looked buried, the goalie got sent off, right or wrong. And after that, you know, we got at them, but then they still looked like scoring, so it must have been a good game to watch.
A Coca-Cola Cup win at Leeds followed, but Ipswich quickly brought Bullies boys back down to earth. They bounced back against Chick Bates' Stoke. Trevor Morley scored twice as the unpredictable Royals recorded only their second away win of the season. Charlton were the next victims. Two first-half goals, including one from Lee Hodges, rewarded the Royals with 3 points as six were booked in a bruising clash. A fighting spirit wasn't enough against leaders Middlesbrough a week later, though all four goals did come in the last 13 minutes. Despite a 0-0 scoreline, Reading's encounter with Wolves was far from dull. Paul Bowden was sent off in the first half, despite being an innocent bystander. To even it out, Wolves midfielder Paul Simpson was sent off 5 minutes later. Despite a chance later on, Bullivant's men had to settle for the 1 point. Today, they'll be aiming for all three. And here is their graph, which doesn't make the most encouraging reading. Up to 17th and then 16th not so long ago, slipped back to 18th. It's possible that they could rise to 14th place with a win today. A little bit unlikely, perhaps. 23 matches and 10 defeats, 5 of them at home, and they only lost 3 at home throughout last season. 21-4, that's the lowest in the division, and already 35 conceded. Carla Saba, £800,000 from Brentford in the summer, leading scorer with 8. Then Trevor Morley, 5 in his last 10. Marlon Williams, 5 as well. Lee Hodges, James Lambert and Michael Mika, their other goal scorers so far. Let's hear from the manager, Terry Bullivant.
Terry, the first thing is, can you give us a view on Dennis Smith's appointment?
Yeah, good. It's a good appointment. He's worked very well over the years, experienced manager, and I'm sure he'll do very well.
Now, you promised us fun and games last time we were here. Are we going to see the same again today?
I don't know. It's the night ones that normally cause the trouble here, but no, it should be a good game.
Now, you yourself have been active in the transfer market this week. Can you tell us a bit about Jason Bowen?
Yeah, I've known Jason a long time. He played for Swansea, done very well. Then he went to Birmingham. Barry Fry, I believe, bought him. He can play either side on the wing, he can play up front, so he's a good addition to the squad.
Now, you remain something of a Jekyll and Hyde side. Are we going to see the good side today?
I hope so, yeah.
And what sort of result are we looking for then?
We want to win today, yeah.
Thanks a lot, Terry.
12 o'clock kickoff at Elm Park. Jason Byrne, by the way, will not make his debut for the Royals, who are looking to get back on track against West Bromwich Albion. They have a pretty miserable record against them over the years. The fans looking in suitably festive spirit, despite the early kickoff. Very mild afternoon at Elm Park. After the break, we'll have a closer look at West Brom's recent form and hear more from the main man of the moment, their new manager, Dennis Smith. Live Rugby Union coming up here on Saturday afternoon as bottom of the table Bristol take on the unbeaten all-star team of Newcastle, a real David and Goliath affair. It's live from the Memorial Ground tomorrow afternoon, 1:30, right here on Sky Sports 2. Right now, we're building up towards kickoff at Elm Park. Dennis Smith's first game as West Bromwich Albion's manager. And there is official confirmation that the Pink Panther is a West Brom fan, and he's got a very big tail. And he's brought his two friends, Minnie and Mickey Mouse, with him to Elm Park. How nice. No problem working out who's had the better of their meetings over the years. 15 wins to 4 in West Brom's favour. And they've won 8 of the last 11, losing only once. Reading have won only once in the last 9 at Elm Park. That was in December 95. Their only other win was in November 1928, when they came out on top by 5-3. The last time they met at Elm Park was exactly 1 year ago today. And it was an entertaining match. 4 goals, the first of them after just 3 minutes for Paul Pesky Solido, who of course has now gone to Fulham in a £1 million plus deal. So that was 1-0 to the Albion. But Reading had a good home record last season. As I said, only 3 home defeats throughout it. A rather lazy equaliser from Lee Nogan in the 8th minute. Albion were back in front before half-time. Paul Groves. But in the second half, Jimmy Quinn popped up with the equaliser 17 minutes from time. 2-2 last season. Let's hope there's similar entertainment this afternoon. Andy Hunt and Trevor Morley, joint favourites to open the scoring. Morley's got 5 in his last 10, Hunt 11 for the season. Carlos Saba, 8 for the season so far. Then Richard Schnakers, who got the win of the last time Albion were live on Sky against Birmingham. And Lee Hodges at 14-1. Now, West Brom finished 16th last season and were never in the top half of the table. This season, they've never been in the bottom half, but their recent form hasn't been encouraging. Neil Webb's my guest in the studio today. This game, Neil, against Manchester City was Ray Harford's last in charge. Paul Dickoff got the only goal and it started a real wobble in form. This was their only win in the last 5 games.
Yeah, they've been disappointing for some reason. I mean, and they lost at home the other week to the bottom club, Huddersfield. So Dennis Smith's got an awful lot to do and turn it around like Ray Harford did.
Alan Johnston with a pretty stunning strike to give Sunderland victory by 2-0. Sunderland, the informed side in the division. And then, as Neil mentioned, a home defeat against the bottom side, Huddersfield. Paul Dalton with both the goals. And Huddersfield climbed 4 places as a result of that win. So Albion are in a spot of bother, but they've stayed near the top throughout. First early on and second for a long period of time. Down to 5th at the moment. They could go 3rd with victory today. 23 matches played. 7 defeats so far, 25 goals scored, only 21 conceded. That's the 3rd best defensive record in the country. But in front of goal, they've been just a little lackadaisical in the past few games. Hunt with 11. Lee Hughes, the man who was signed from non-league Kidderminster in the summer, has picked up 5. Schnaker's 4. And then Hamilton, Kilbane and Marden, 1 apiece. Well, it is a big day for Dennis Smith, and he's now talking to our reporter, Alan Bentley.
Dennis, first thing, any regrets about leaving Oxford?
Well, there's always regrets. I mean, I put 4 odd years working there and there were some nice people to work with. But West Brom are a far bigger club and hopefully I can fulfil my ambitions there and the ambitions of West Brom.
Now, looking at today, what's been your input into the picking of the side?
Very little. We had a meeting Christmas Eve in the morning before I met the press and for an hour with the staff, with John, with Richie, with Cyril. I had a discussion with them. Asked them what they thought was going to be the best side to play today. They came up with this squad and I could only agree with them. It was very difficult to disagree and I think that was the best way of going about it. We had a practice match in the afternoon, had a little look at them, quite happy with what I saw, and so we'll wait and see.
How do you see today's game going?
Hopefully going well. Apparently they played very well the last couple of away games without getting the results they would like at Middlesbrough and Sunderland. So if they've played well, then hopefully they'll continue that today.
Thanks a lot, Dennis.
He's an affable man, and he'll be looking towards Andy Hunt in particular today, Neil, won't he? Hunt has been the main striker as far as Albion are concerned this season.
Yeah, I always find that's a bit of a worry when one club relies so much on one person to get all the goals. Like you say, I mean, he's got 10 or 11 overall this season, which is six more than the next one in the team. So really, they've got to start spreading it around, although Andy Hunt's playing up front on his own an awful lot.
Seems to like playing against Reading. He got a hat-trick against them last season. Do you think players do have special teams that they particularly enjoy playing against?
Yeah, for some strange reason, it does happen like that way, that you know, he scored the goal at West Brom earlier this season to beat Reading up there. And it just seems that he likes playing against
Is there any logic as to why players do so well against certain sides?
No, none at all. It's just, obviously, he just likes it down at Elm Park and he likes putting the ball in the net.
Well, Trevor Morley tends to do well against all sides. Terrific record over the years and such a brave player because he's had his fair share of nasty injuries, hasn't he?
Well, a few other players might have called it a day, especially after having a plate inserted into his skull. But Trevor's been he's vital to Reading. He's helped Asaba, especially, because Asaba started very, very slowly. But Trevor's come in, he holds the ball up well, he links play, and he knows where the goal is, certainly. And he's spring chicken at 36, is he?
That's right. I mean, he's getting on, but he was player of the year last season with 23 goals. And as you get towards the end of your career, I suppose you savour every strike that little bit more.
But especially after the injuries that Trevor's received lately. I mean, that one with the head, that was awful, awful challenge. And for him to come back and to still scoring goals with his head is a tremendous feat.
And a brief word about Carl Asaba, £800,000, 8 goals so far. Do you think he's been value for money up to now?
Well, he wasn't at the start of the season. He was a very slow starter. He was getting a lot of stick from the crowd. They couldn't understand why they paid £800,000 for a striker that he was playing outside the box. He was going wide. He wasn't getting in the box. And all of a sudden, with Trevor's coming into the team, he started scoring goals again, and got to be happy with him.
OK, very quickly, who is going to win this match?
I'm going to have to say Reading, being the hometown, seeing as I've got to go back there this afternoon, so I'm going for a 2-1 home victory.
2-1 for Reading. Will Neil be right? We're about to find out. Our commentators on this Boxing Day occasion are Alan Brazil and Rob Hawthorne.
Season's greetings from Elm Park, where West Brom fans didn't quite get what they wanted for Christmas if the supporter polls backing John Truick were accurate. But supporters can't appoint a new manager, and in Dennis Smith, Albion's board has engaged a man of sound pedigree. And while Albion parade their new manager, Reading boss Terry Bullivant keeps his present in the wrapping for at least the start of this fixture. Jason Bowen, their Christmas Eve capture from Birmingham, is on the bench as the side shows just one change from that which drew with Wolves in their last match. Steve Swales has recovered from flu and he displaces Paul Bowden, who's on the bench.
Yeah, 4-4-2 for Reading today, and boy, do they need a home win. Hammond in goal, Booty, Bernal and Davis, very important today that they keep tight together, battle away. Bernal especially, good competitor. Swales on the left, four across the middle, Williams, Hodges, Parkinson and Lambert. Do you remember that glorious goal last time we were here against Nottingham Forest? Cracking, full of pace, lovely tricks, needs a little bit more consistency. And up front, Morley, 5 goals in the last 10 games, and Carl Asaba, £800,000 signing from Brentford. Will he hit the back of the net this afternoon?
As we've heard, West Brom's side has basically been selected by the caretaker partnership of Richie Barker and John Truick, with some input from Dennis Smith. Changes were always likely after the 2-0 home defeat by Huddersfield, and David Smith comes in for Tony Dobson at left-back, with Sean Flynn returning in place of Bob Taylor as West Brom return to the 4-5-1 setup that served them so well with Andy Hunt as the lone striker.
Yeah, I think Dennis Smith will be delighted with the goals conceded record at West Bromwich Albion, in a lofty position in the first division, but stuttering of late. Miller, I think he's one of the reasons why, in goals, Alan Miller, they don't concede too many. Top class for me. And the four across the back, McDermott, Burgess and Marden. Burgess and Marden, I feel, good, strong, good combination. David Smith, left-hand side. And then the midfield, Flynn on the right. Tough, gets stuck in, tracks back. Butler, he's the holding player for West Brom, along with Hamilton. Hamilton does venture forward a little bit. Coban, for me, is an out-and-out winger. Lovely, strong runner of the ball. Looks to get in these positions down the left-hand side. And watch for Snakers. Many times we've covered West Brom this season. Loves his runs forward. And Andy Hunt, prolific for West Brom this season.
And out they come to enjoy the Boxing Day atmosphere. West Brom near the camera. Reading in the blue and white. And West Brom may be in the grip of a bad run of results at the moment, but coming into this match, they were only 5 points behind the division's leaders. So can they arrest the crisis and give new manager Dennis Smith a winning start? It's Reading against West Bromwich Albion. The whole match coming up after the break.
Dennis Smith's first game as manager of West Bromwich Albion is just about to start. Reading, the opponents at Elm Park today. We will keep you up to date with all the other early kickoffs up and down the country. But for now, it's back to our commentators, Alan Brazil and Rob Hawthorne.
Dennis Smith is West Bromwich Albion's eighth manager in 10 years, so it is a very hot, hot seat. And he was a late runner in the managerial stakes. Lots of names were mentioned when the vacancy occurred, people like Joe Royle and David Pleat. But he's a man who's had four promotions in his career so far, so he's got a sound pedigree and a good record that the West Brom fans are hoping can continue at the Hawthorns. Here, though, Reading, who've not won or scored in their last two matches, get the game started. And Butler slides in straight away on Martin Williams to let him know that he's there.
That's Peter Butler for you, isn't it? Doesn't get any goals, or many goals, as you say, but loves a tackle.
Here's Asaba. And Williams, boosted by the arrival of Jason Bowen, knows that he's got to impress. And he's made a great start looking for Morley, and Morley's bundled it in! What a start for Reading, and what a devastating blow for Dennis Smith. A goal down just over 30 seconds into his first game.
Well, what a start for the home side. And really, defensively, McDermott and Miller get in all sorts of trouble. Williams, who took that bad tackle by Butler, whips it across. Morley gets the final touch. Perhaps Miller has pushed or punched the ball onto Morley. But Williams had picked himself up, ducks inside here on the left foot. Morley with a near post run. Out comes Miller. Miller gets a touch and in off Morley. What a start. Good play from Williams. Great delivery, Miller gets a punch off Morley in the back of the net.
Well, it is Trevor Morley's sixth goal of the season. Three of those have been penalties. And indeed, too many of Reading's goals lately have been from the penalty spot. He's a great poacher of goals, and that was a fine example of one as he leapt in on Alan Miller, who pushed the ball onto him, but the goalkeeper appeared to have been injured in that and had some extensive treatment immediately after that goal had been conceded. But normally they say that when you take over as a manager, it's because a team is in some sort of crisis. You look at the table, see West Brom a fifth, and think that isn't the case with Dennis Smith, but he's just had an early indication of Albion's current problems.
Wow, with a smashing, teasing cross from Martin Williams. And Miller, well, Miller may be a little bit unlucky, but Morley got inward at heart. We're at six goals in 11 games for Trevor Morley.
But an early shock for Dennis Smith. Wonder if he's signed the contract yet and if he might be thinking again.
It's a manager's nightmare, isn't it? First attack and you concede. Still, long way to go.
Well, they say you learn a lot about your team when they're losing, so maybe he will learn a few lessons from this. In a perverse sort of way, it might be just the sort of start that Dennis Smith needed to see what his team is made of.
Really, it was a near post ball, wasn't it? And Morley, you know, he's terrible injuries over the years, but made a good run to the near post, got in with it hurts, and Alan Miller in goal for West Brom, punching it against Morley and lying hopelessly as the ball hit the back of the net.
Here's Booty with the McDermott with a free kick. Cleared by Swales. But what a great psychological ploy by Terry Bullivant. Martin Williams put in the team knowing that Jason Bowen is lying in wait for his place on the substitute bench, and he immediately delivers with the cross that led to the goal.
Yeah, that was just after a tough tackle from Peter Butler. Picked himself up and great delivery.
Cleared by Lambert.
Sorry,
Crossing with Lambert and Hunt.
Oh, what a start. Williams, good dummy. That's Burgess's dummy. Whipped it in. Miller gets a touch. And it does. Does it hit Morley or does it hit the defender? That could be McDermott's goal. Miller with a punch. It hits McDermott. But Reading go one up.
And here goes Schnakers. Hunt pushing up ahead. Well, a dramatic start to proceedings here at Elm Park. Here's McDermott. Felt the full horror of that. Morley. Williams. Pushing up on his right was Booty. This is Davis. Williams. Parkinson hoping for Morley. McDermott lets that one go. The nerves of the entire Albion defence must be jangling at the moment. So desperate to impress their new manager, and they couldn't have got off to a worse start.
Well, normally so solid at the back, you know, that's why away from home they like this. Andy Hunt up front on his own, five across the midfield, make it tough. But Williams certainly exposed them there. And really, I don't think you can blame the fullback McDermott. Miller, you know, punching the ball out a yard away, just hit him.
And Hunt. No handball given. This is Schnakers.
Yeah, he was a bit slow there, wasn't he? The crowd shouted handball. I don't think he was giving it for handball. Offside was his decision.
Andy Durso from Billericay in Essex is today's match official.
You can see he takes it, it just rolls down his hand. There's a little touch, and the linesman clearly had a flag up.
Reading came into this game with 234 minutes without a goal. Indeed, four of the last eight they've scored have come from the penalty spot. But they've had a perfect start to this game. Swales. Davis.
That's a hair drop.
I think he was aiming for us.
And Gareth Davis, delighted. A great start. Tell me it was an impressive debut last week.
West Brom have lost and failed to score in four of their last five matches.
That's the problem, I think, the Baggies have got. Andy Hunt, it's so crucial that Hunt gets the goals from. They've really got to start sharing a few. And they need more goals if they have got any chance of promotion. I just wonder if Dennis Smith has got some money to spend, Rob. Maybe that's part of the deal. I think he needs it for the Baggies to get up.
Snakers. Going to kill Van. Get the crossing from a tight angle. Put back across by Flynn. And well hit by Hamilton! Brilliant save!
Yeah, good stop from Hammond. Ian Hamilton must have thought he's equalised. But Hammond, flying save to the right-hand side. Hamilton lurking on the edge of the box. Hooked back in. Body's in front of Hammond, but look at this. Good stop, nice height for the keeper with the left hand. Just gets a palm on it over the top.
More work for the goalkeeper here. Schnakers hits one, and another flyer.
Well, that is a quality save this time from Hammond. Hamilton's shot was a nice height, but Snakers had more power on it. Reading really have to watch this 18-yard line. As the ball's knocked out, another West Brom player, Snakers, blasts. Good touch from Hammond.
They're driving forward here. Flynn came in. Cleared to Hamilton. Here's a sub. Reading grateful to break. Grateful to their goalkeeper for preserving the lead. McDermott. Here's Asaba.
Good start to the match. Goodness me. Asaba looking sharp, quick feet. Looks strong and powerful, Carl Asaba. People felt maybe 800,000 from Brentford was too much. He's proven it with goals. How Reading and Terry Bullivant need those goals.
It's Lambert's free kick. Morley will go for it. Aaron Miller and his opposite number, Nicky Hammond, both former Arsenal apprentices. Hammond really has had a cracking start to this game. Those two superb saves from Hamilton and Schnakers.
Yeah, as you've seen, Reading have got to be very careful. They've got to protect Nicky Hammond a little bit more, especially at set pieces, the flick-ons. And as the ball comes out to the edge of the box, they really have to get good jerseys alongside the likes of Snakers and Hamilton, looking for the knockdowns. It's lovely if you're a goalkeeper and you get a couple of early saves, confidence brimming. I don't know if I can blame Alan Miller, Rob, because it was a good ball in. And he knocked him out. Unfortunately, his own fullback McDermott in the way before he could react in the back of the net. 1-0.
Asaba, Morley, Asaba giving chase. And here's McDermott.
Asaba, whose pace could be a problem. The two centre-halves, Marden and Burgess, tough, strong, like to attack the ball, but the ball in behind sometimes catches them out. Not blessed with tremendous pace either.
It's Hodges. This is Andrew McDermott. Flynn. To release Hamilton, who'll be expected to be one of the runners from the midfield to support Hunt.
Yeah, it was a good run from Hamilton. Snakers and Hamilton will make them runs all afternoon, especially now a goal down. As Butler, he's the holding player.
Foul on Flynn, who wants to get on with it and take the free kick quickly, and McDermott has come forward to offer him an option.
This is where Reading, for me, have been looking a little bit dodgy. The ball's in the box, West Brom seem to be getting the first touch.
Hamilton in there again. It's Kilbane's free kick, Marden challenging. And it's punched within greater distance by Phil Parkinson.
Really, apart from that opening, I wouldn't say it's been a decent start from West Bromwich Albion on the travels. A couple of good strikes on goal, Hammond's been excellent. But lots of possession from the wayside.
They've responded in the manner that would have been expected of them anyway. But obviously under Dennis Smith, all of the players are keen to prove their worth. And Hunt has turned away from Davis. Flynn has made a break in the box as it whips right across the face of goal.
Oh, Flynn, Sean Flynn, flying in at the far post. And maybe Andy Hunt might have been better just clipping it across. I think this is a drive for the far post. Bang, and that's not far away. Look at Flynn as well, diving in. Beats the keeper and a whisker past the far post.
Andy Bernal. McDermott with a throw.
Glorious afternoon. Marcus earlier, Rob was saying how, you know, how mild it was. The sun's out, but I promise you the wind is biting.
One or two of the crowd with their new woolly jumpers, happy to have got them now. Andy Hunt winning the throw off for Andy Bernal. West Brom have gained 3 points out of the nine available since Ray Harford had left.
There's a late challenge there, I think it was Lambert on Butler. Or Parkinson on Butler, sorry. Peter Butler drops these knees. Just here, watch the late challenge there. It's more a stamp on the left foot. Parks is a tough character, so is Butler mind.
Phil Parkinson was the character with whom Mark McGee had a little altercation at the end of the recent goalless draw here with Wolves, a game that's always played in high tempo when McGee returns. After that no-nonsense challenge, Butler is on his feet, although protesting heavily. It's Kilban's free kick. Martin aiming to get there and does! And cleared by Bernal.
Wow, I thought that was a great chance. Bernal was watching Hunt at the far post. Marden rises above everyone from Kilban's cross. Look at Hunt in behind Bernal. And that's a good clearance. Really had to make sure Andy Bernal.
Lenz's corner was in towards Burgess. Cleared to Butler. Hamilton. Hunt had pulled free. Butler.
It's going to be a good battle. Parkinson and Butler today. Sparks are flying.
Two tough, no-nonsense characters.
Yeah, this is going to be, we're going to see a bit of this all day. Nothing bad in it. Good competitors both.
Asaba. Lambert. He can run at defenders.
Yeah, trying the left foot strike. Full of tricks, but this time going for power and not troubling Alan Miller.
Number 80 in Hamilton. Parkinson coming back on him this time, giving away the free kick. Here's Richard Schnakers. It's McDermott's cross. Right in between Hunt and Kilban. Long clearance by Hammond that had Miller back pedalling for a short while.
I just feel that's where the Baggies have got to be careful, West Brom. Asaba's pace through the middle. I just feel Reading now beginning. Well, they've got to start winning the knockdowns in midfield because West Brom are patient, they're passing the ball. They seem first in the knockdowns and not intimidated by this early goal.
Smith, there's Bernal. Andy Bernal, who was actually sent off in this fixture last year. Remember, Reading and West Brom played each other on Boxing Day last season as well, but that red card was later revoked when the referee looked again at the evidence. Leading with his arm, no handball given. Butler having to really dig in hard, and then Morley going in too hard against him.
Morley's foot was up, there's nothing nasty in it. The referee was only a few yards away. Butler helping it on, there's a challenge there. Good refereeing, and again Butler involved.
Butler and Morley, who had 2 years together at West Ham. Smith, the sight set very firmly on goal.
Just as he hit this, David Smith, there was just a tiny little bobble which lifted the ball well over the crossbar. Again, quick free kick from West Brom. Smith thinks no one's closing, why not? Just bobbling and bouncing, no problem for Hammond.
Burgess, caught by Trevor Morley. Burgess, who's taking the free kick, the main man at Albion, who's seen all the managerial changes now, currently playing for the seventh manager of his first team career. Parkinson, Asaba, Burgess. Kilban will put pressure here on Booty. He did well, this is Williams. Parkinson. It's Marden scurrying back here, troubled by the pace of Asaba.
This fella's getting a bit of stick, you know. But four or five times he's been on his backside now, Martin Williams. Kilbane this time leaning in. A few moments earlier, Hamilton just caught him off the ball.
Martin Williams, who was being played as a lone striker earlier in the season by Terry Bullivant. A lot of people feel that of late he's maybe just gone off the boil. He started this match in flying style, and he's going for that one again against Kilbane. Parkinson against Butler, this clash of the titans. Hunt aware that Snakers had made a great run. Just too much on it for him.
Great awareness from Andy Hunt. Snakers obviously talking to him. But when the ball goes out on his left foot, Hunt immediately just tries to slot it into the running of Snakers.
Always a threat, Richard Snakers. Scored in West Brom's last two victories over Birmingham, which we saw live on Sky, and against Stockport. The only match that West Brom have won since Ray Harford departed. Hunt. There's Lambert.
This fella's been in the wars. A few times found himself on his backside. It was early on when Peter Butler came in with a strong challenge on the little fella. Doing well there, just coming inside the big centre-half. Good ball in the near post. Miller punched it against McDermott. That's the opening goal. Again, a little bit late. Williams again on the ground. Has he said something about West Brom, this boy? Or?
Here's Martin Booty. Morley. Hodges arriving. The answer is by Flynn.
It's a game I thought before the match, Rob, that West Brom had to get something out of just to stop this run. Just install a bit of confidence, especially in the new manager.
Booty, made by McDermott. Every team does have their bad run at some stage of the season, and many pundits might argue that some of West Brom's performances have been catching up with them with their results of late. It's a question of how quickly they can stop the slide now to maintain their place in the promotion frame.
That's nice as well, though. It's a nice position to be halfway. As you say, they must improve.
Smith under pressure from Morley. That's Gareth Davis.
Done well to get his goals, Andy Hunt, all alone up front. It's not an easy position to play. Good movement he's got, but desperate for the runs, for the support quickly up to him.
Lambert. Nice bomb throw.
Very condensed in the midfield, Rob. That's why it's not fast and flowing. It's a little bit, you know, it's a bit bitty. The ball's dropping to players, and there's three, four players around them, especially in the midfield areas.
Saba. Booty. There's Butler. Burgess. Parkinson, Snakers, nice touch to Flynn, Swales, and here's McDermott. Butler, David Smith. Snakers and Hamilton just supporting Hunt at the edge of the penalty area. Peter Butler. Spot to see the offence committed against Booty.
Yeah, it's the usual one, the fullback just about to play up the line. Hamilton definitely late. Wasn't high, his feet weren't high, but he catches Booty on the ankle. It's a lunge, isn't it? And that's why the referee is going to take action.
And it's the first caution of the game. Ian Hamilton given the yellow card.
Sometimes it's just the ball's there and you realise you're a bit late, but you just commit yourself. You know you're going to catch the fullback. You just hope maybe the ref's not too close, but this time Andy Dussel was very close by.
Well, this is the second successive Boxing Day meeting of these two teams. It was West Brom who were early to strike last year with the opening goal in the third minute. Reading were level by the eighth and the game finished 2-2. Had a goal, an own goal from Andrew McDermott in the opening minute of this encounter. West Brom have continued to threaten since. Morley, Swales to Parkinson. Oh, I wonder if Reading have just taken their foot off the pedal after that wonderful start they had.
I think Reading are having a problem with the five in midfield, but it's no problem when you're one up, but to get the game flowing, there's five West Brom players strung right across the park and there's no space in there. And Dennis Smith will be saying, OK, we need a little bit more. I know, Hamilton had a good shot, Snakers had a good shot, but they've just stopped as well, West Brom, creating the chances. I think he'll be looking for a little bit more from Kevin Coban on the left-hand side. I've not seen too much of him.
Bullivant might just be a little concerned at the way that his team is failing to break down this West Brom midfield. It's a familiar pattern that Albion have readopted.
Yeah, I think you'll also be concerned, Rob, with the set pieces, that they're not dealing with them better, not clearing the lines.
And there goes Palasaba, and he's through. Marden recovered.
Well, Marden done well there to stick to his guns, because Asaba, good trickery, got clear. David Smith comes over to help his centre-half out, and Marden kept going. Asaba, suddenly he's faced with Smith, comes inside, and Marden covers well.
First Reading corner to be taken by Lambert. Phil Bann. Lambert with a second bite at the cherry. Williams!
2-0! And Williams, who caused havoc for the first goal, scores the second.
Well, one thing for sure, West Bromwich Albion can't deal with near post crosses. Beautiful ball in the box, and Williams cuts inside the 6-yard line and side foots home. Good play from Lambert, whips it in. Again, a teasing cross. Good finish. From provider to goal scorer. Martin Williams, 2-0.
Drop me now, boss, he's saying, after the signing of Jason Bowen.
Poor Jason Bowen sitting in the bench saying, what did I come here for? Ah, smash and go. Dennis Smith will be very angry, whereas this fella, Terry Bullivant, delighted. Just when they were going a little bit cold on him, pop up with a second goal. Williams, who's come in from the right-hand side midfield to head for a near post, almost near the centre in the end of the time he tucked it in, but a cool finish.
Reading don't have wads of cash to splash around. The signing of Jason Byrne cost them £200,000, but Williams, a free transfer signing from Luton some time ago, is perhaps showing them that they could have kept the cheque unsigned. And as he's being taunted with cries of Dennis, what's the score, he's come downstairs to make a few observations to John Truick, the new West Brom manager. West Brom showed plenty of spirit after losing the first goal, and are now determined to prove that the second goal hasn't killed them off. Cross from Kilban. Beyond Hunt, Flynn came in, and it's cleared by Davis.
That's good play from Flynn, coming in from a wide right position. Getting his header in, but Reading get it clear again. It's really crosses West Brom, I think, look more dangerous. But they need one back quick.
We've seen great Reading fight backs here at Elm Park. They were 3-0 down against Crewe, drew 3-3. They were 3-1 down against Forest and came back to 3-3. But now, if there's to be a revival, it has to come from their opponents.
Hunt starts to come deeper and deeper, looking for the ball. Good player, but you can't do it all up on your own there. You can hold it up, but when you're surrounded by blue and white jerseys, you need support and quick. Snakers and Hamilton have to take more chances now. 2-0, now that they're 2-0 down.
Andy Hunt scored a hat-trick against Reading last season. And I'm sure a similar repeat performance wouldn't go amiss today. Here's Hamilton.
Please, Dennis Smith. Sean Flynn on the left, all on his own. Looking across the line. Is he offside? Just. Good decision.
Reading came into this game as the First Division's lowest scorers in the league, with just 21 to their credit. They have managed to put West Brom in a real predicament in Dennis Smith's first game in charge, and the plight may worsen yet. Williams is really on his game today. He's left himself with too much to do there as Kilban came back to provide extra cover. Kevin Kilban. Hamilton. Here's McDermott. Flynn.
Yeah, he spotted it on a McDermott Flynn that tried to do it a little bit too early. A little bit unlucky McDermott in that first OG.
Maybe unlucky there.
Had the chances, West Brom, haven't they? You know, they get the ball in the box, plenty of support around the 18-yard line. But good goalkeeping from Hammond.
Reminder of more Boxing Day football to come, with Aston Villa against Tottenham from the Premiership on Sky Sports 1 from 4 o'clock. And then Sunday football from Bramall Lane. Our nationwide league coverage begins at 12 noon. Sheffield United against Charlton on Sky Sports 2.
Big question there, Rob. Will Stan the man be playing for the Villa? It's not been a merry Christmas for him.
Up against Carla Saba.
Saba didn't like the decision. Just there, you can see a good yard offside. Both fans didn't like it, but the ref was correct.
When West Brom need goals, in the past they've often looked to Lee Hughes, and it's to this raw talent of the 21-year-old that they're looking again. They've taken Sean Flynn off, and Hughes, who scored 5 goals, all of them from the bench this season, is now given the task by Dennis Smith of rescuing something from his first game in charge. Good play here from Hunt, it's good pressure from Albion, and he's made room for Kevin Kilban to drive it across, and it's off Bernal for the corner.
Well, I think, first of all, I think it's a brave decision by Dennis Smith. 33 minutes gone, it's not working, Hunt's exposed, and suddenly Hunt's involved. Gives it wide on the left to Kilban, it bubbles, Burnell comes off him, and Hammond's all over the shot.
How costly could the conceding of this corner be? Number 8, Hamilton. His target is Lee Hughes. Cleared by Morley. But Dennis Smith has done a lot of listening in his first few days in charge, and he's liked what he's heard about Lee Hughes. I don't think it'll be too long before Smith is putting him in his starting lineup. manager have basically picked today's team in consultation with the caretaker partnership, but for the two games coming up against Stoke, one in the league and one in the FA Cup, it will be Smith's say for the selection of the side.
It's a little bit unlucky on Sean Flynn, you know, but when you're 2-0 down, you have to change it. And I just feel that Lee Hughes will help Andy Hunt alongside. You know, he was getting the ball. In the end, Hunt was coming too deep for it, Rob. He was getting frustrated, been up there all alone. So this fellow will give him a bit of firepower alongside him.
Well, he scored a couple after coming off the bench against Crewe. What can he do here at Elm Park? It's a short one from Martin for Smith, and he just managed to get there ahead of Williams.
Williams having a terrific game.
They're really dicing the danger when they're playing around when Williams is attendant. Schnakers, it was a good touch from Hunt. Hughes. Schnakers. McDermott.
Yeah, Terry Bullivant, he'd be saying it himself and his boys, come on, 10 minutes, don't concede. 2-0, we go in at half-time comfortable. 2-1, it's a different matter. No silly mistakes, but once again, set pieces, I think, Albion are dangerous. And once again, they have one.
Hughes will look to profit from it.
Hughes with the right foot, and it's the slightest of touches from Lambert. The corner, right-hand side.
Kilbane's corner, and it's too short for Burgess, cleared by Swales. McDermott. Marden and Burgess have stayed in attack, and that is not very clever with Williams looking to break, but he just can't get there in time.
I tell you what, David Smith took a big chance there. You know, whether he read that ball was going out, David Smith, the fullback, went over to Williams and left Asaba all alone through the middle. Williams again, breaking. Look at Smith going across in. Asaba's all alone. Just as well, the ball rolls out.
Turned out by Darryl Burgess.
I think they'll be very disappointed. Burgess and Paul Marden, when the ball's been whipped into the near post, they haven't, you know, looked solid at all.
Saba onside, Morley and Williams going into the area. Turned behind by David Smith.
Once again, they're ready to two at the far post against one. Saba gets clear, maybe a hint of offside, but look, Williams at the far post and Morley through the middle, two against one.
Remember, have beaten West Brom just twice in 11 league games here. It's a record they stand a great chance of improving if they can hold on to or even add to this 2-0 lead. And they might be a big threat from this situation. It's Martin Booty's corner. And Davis going into challenge.
Oh, Miller was right underneath it. He really hasn't had a save to make, Alan Miller. Picked the ball out the back of net twice. It's a high cross, the wind gets a hold of it. Miller's underneath it, in comes Davis. Free kick. Clearly see Davis's left arm up.
Many who believe that Alan Miller was the best signing of Ray Harford's tenure. Pinal.
Two centre-halves are ready and doing well. They're following the runs from the midfield, the likes of Hamilton and this time Snakers. Bunnell and Davies are doing well.
There's Kilbane. Oh, well, Andy Hunt, the sort of header that normally you would have expected him to tuck away.
Yeah, glorious chance from Andy Hunt. Applauds the service. And Kilbane again, this time on the right foot, whipping in. And really, Andy Hunt, in a rich vein of form, you'd expect to knock this one away. Good service from Kilbane. Hunt between the two centre-halves and over the top.
He's almost had what seems like a grudge against Reading. 6 goals against them in 7 league appearances for West Brom.
Tell you what, Rob, it's definitely windier than it looks. Out there, the ball, I think West Brom's second half can cause the home side a lot of trouble with putting the ball in the box, because it is a vicious swirling wind down there. Saba. Davis! Getting across, getting above Kilbane at the far post. You say to yourself, what's Davis doing up there? The centre-half signed from Palace, a sweeping cross, plenty high, and Davis gets over Kilbane. Wind again playing a part, but Miller had it covered.
Charles Davis, newly joined Reading, but making his 150th career appearance today. Smith. Play from Bernard. Morley. Booty. And he's unleashed. Williams again with the Saba going into the box. So too is Lambert. And it was a crucial touch from McDermott. Here's Wales. Reading continuing to turn the screw. Cleared by Smith. Only to Williams. Booty. Three were waiting.
Yeah, that's a good finish to the first half from Reading. And Williams really is causing havoc. This time doesn't cut back on the left foot. Decides as an opening. Saba making the run. Lambert at the far post. And that's a good flick from O'Donnell.
Williams has gone down, but no free kick has been given. And it's been given away, though, by Hamilton. And Reading continue to finish the first half strongly. Saba, Davis has stayed in the attack once more. But it's cleared by McDermott.
McDermott and Smith are having a bad time, the fullbacks for West Brom. Saba causing problems with his pace.
Lambert. Booty. Williams.
Yeah. That's a late challenge. Thank goodness Morley's to his feet, saying okay. Butler the culprit. Sees the ball, and this fella doesn't hold back, Peter Butler. In goes the challenge, Morley down, and the referee again on hand.
Well, Butler may have helped his opponent back to his feet, but doesn't escape a yellow card.
He's a holding player. Anything loose, he's got to challenge for. And mistiming it.
Morley is now back on his feet and waiting at the edge of the area, while Miller now worries himself about the four Reading players over the free kick. Booty, Parkinson, Lambert, and Hodges are the quartet. And it's lined up for Lee Hodges. Well charged down by Butler.
Yeah, he had to redirect himself, Butler, but a good free kick.
Cross from Swales towards Morley, cleared by Burgess. Hodges came in looking for a strike. Just fended off by Schnakers, and Hughes is free. If Hunt can pick him out on the right, and he's found him. But Reading have flooded players back. And the cross from Hughes is cleared. Here's Hughes. A useful break that had been made by Lee Hughes, but West Brom couldn't make the most of it.
Hunt spotted him, it was just the pass was too strong. It was a great opportunity for Albion.
Is it going to have been their last opportunity of the first half, or can they manufacture something here? Well, not like that from Schnakers, they can't.
Yeah, they tried to thread it in between the fullback and centre half for Hughes, but really the chance was missed, wasn't it? Hunt had a great opportunity to find Lee Hughes. And Reading have just got to keep this tight right up to half time. Albion still look dangerous on the break, but defensively they look fragile.
Hughes. McDirt. Bernal. Header only lands for Andy Hunt. And he's lined it up for Hamilton, who's got Kilbane to his left. Kevin Kilbane! Side netting.
Yeah, he got his strike away. The problem is the pitch here at Elm Park is a little bit boggling and bumpy. Kilbane gets a lovely ball from Hamilton, who spots him on the left-hand side. Decides to hit it first time, should be going across the goal, and just wide into the side netting. Not going to trouble Nicky Hammond. And another chance goes a-begging for the Baggies.
They get a cup draw here, it could be West Brom's last ever performance at Elm Park, with Reading due to move home next season. Morley here looking to get through against McDermott. Traditionally they've had good times here of West Brom.
So well, this game is one of these games, Rob, but I think the players will tell you it's not enjoyable because it's windy, the pitch is bumpy and the ball's bobbly. The first touch has got to be excellent. That ball looks out of shape to me.
So that's what Miller would say.
Yeah, the way it's in flight, the ball looks to be, it just looks as if it's a little bit out of shape. Or maybe it's the wind, or maybe it's my eyes.
Let's see what effect the wind is having on the flag on the rooftops. And will that be to West Brom's advantage after the break? Reading, though, have given themselves a commanding advantage in this match.
I think the second goal was a killer, Rob. Came at a nice time for Reading.
Schnakers. Kilbane. Hamilton, Hunt, Hughes, all waiting in the box. And off Booty.
Kilbane's had a couple of chances, hasn't he, against Booty? You know, he's got in at the far post and strike a couple of shots across the face of the goal and one into side netting.
Big guns have come forward from the back. Burgess near post, Marvin far post. Corner doesn't clear the first Reading defender. Kilbane, though, gets it in. And the header off the post from Marvin. Kilbane, first cross blocked. Kilbane with a second opportunity. And Marden, the man who hit the post with a header that really caught Reading by surprise, couldn't get the last cross.
Wow, how unlucky can you be? Paul Marden, this is a good header, over the head of Hunt. Marden pings it back to where it comes from. Goalkeeper stranded and beaten.
Latest cross in there towards Kilbane, he can't get there. Reading's goal leading a charmed life towards the end of the first half. Dermot. Hunt.
What a time to score that there'd be. Dennis Smith must be cursing. Teddy Bullivant, wow. She's a good lead. Could have been also different.
Half time, and Dennis Smith hasn't done too much talking, mainly listening in his time as Albion manager so far, but plenty of talking to do now after Trevor Morley's pressure forced McDermott to concede an own goal barely 30 seconds into the first match of Smith's reign. It was a great break from Williams, the cross completely foxed the Albion defence, and Miller pushed the ball onto the on-rushing defender, McDermott's own goal, and Reading one up in the first minute. The second goal, though, was from Williams, a thoroughly deserved one for his efforts too, and Albion trailing 2-0 at half-time.
On Sunday, our nationwide action comes from Bramall Lane. It's Sheffield United at home to Charlton, two sides with big hopes of making at least the playoffs at the end of this season. Sky Sports 2, 12 o'clock on Sunday. Half-time at Elm Park, Reading lead West Bromwich Albion by 2-0. And that won't do Albion's playoff hopes any good at all. They've had more attempts at goal than the home side. 3-2 in Reading's favour on target. 6-2 in Albion's favour. They've had the chances. They have not taken them. They have picked up 2 bookings, Ian Hamilton and Peter Butler. And the action areas make interesting reading after the first 45 minutes. Look at that, Albion on top and 57% of possession. Despite that, they are losing 2-0. And it was the worst possible start as far as Dennis Smith was concerned. Neil Webb is my guest today. What on earth will Dennis have been thinking after the first 32 seconds?
Oh, I think, what am I doing here? I mean, they even took the kick-off as well. It went out for a throw-in. And Reading started the game tremendously well and got the early goal. I mean, Trevor Morley was brave enough to go in there to cause problems.
Well, we'll have another look at it. Dennis Smith has probably just sat down. He's adjusting his seat. He's having a quick word with his friend on the right. And he's seen the ball go out of play, and at this stage, everything's going very nicely for him.
That was a great tackle there on Williams himself.
I mean, so he's a happy man after 10 seconds.
So he's happy now, and Reading are taking their time with this throw-in. And it just breaks. They get a couple of lucky breaks. I think Asaba here, it hits Morley and goes straight to Williams' path. Great run. I mean, great run. He does well here because no one's in the box. He's at the cutback. Good crossing, and Trevor's done exceptionally well there. And unfortunately for the fullback, the goalkeeper's pushed it onto his knee.
We talked before the game about what a brave player Trevor Morley is. No hesitation at getting stuck in where it can hurt there.
Exactly. I mean, that's what a centre-forward is all about. He's got to go in where it hurts, and Trevor's brave there. The goalkeeper's done everything right. He's pushed it away from danger, but the fullback is just in the wrong position.
It's McDermott who gets the final touch. So is that an own goal?
It is an own goal because it was actually going away from goal and the fullback deflected it into the net. So unfortunately for Trevor, he's not going to get another goal.
I'm sure if you see Trevor later on this afternoon, you won't be saying that. He'll be claiming it, won't he?
I think he will be claiming it. I think if you look at his reaction as well, straight after the goal, he knows that he hasn't touched it and he's sort of looking a bit sheepishly.
He'll be crossing his fingers. No doubt about who scored the second goal. Marlon Williams turning from provider to goal scorer. Another teasing cross which the Albion defence simply can't deal with.
Yeah, for some reason the Albion, especially the 2 centre-backs, are all over the place. I mean, great cross from Lambert there. I mean, that's the sort of balls that any forward would thrive on, and Williams has tremendous run in and tucked it away nicely.
Bizarre, really, because West Brom have the 3rd best defensive record in the First Division, and yet time and time again, Reading have caused real problems when they've bombed the ball inside the area.
Yeah, and always one centre-forward is getting away from the centre-back, and Smith's having to come across and leaving Williams all alone marked at the far post. And like I say, after the first goal, West Brom had enough chances, really, to get back into the game.
They certainly did, and 2 good saves from Nicky Hammond in very quick succession. The first of them from Ian Hamilton, who strikes it very well. Good height, I suppose, for the keeper, isn't it?
Great height for the keeper, yeah. I mean, it's not that far away from his body, but he's still got to get a good, strong wrist there to push it away. And this is a tremendous strike. And again, the goalkeeper's just a fingertip save, just enough to put it over the bar.
Richard Schnakers gives that everything, plus the kitchen sink.
Exactly, yeah. Great strike, but the keeper there is on form early on. But then West Brom go and hit the post as well. So really, they needed a goal before half-time. To go in 2-1 is obviously a lot better than 2-0. And Dennis Smith's got a lot of talking to do there, especially got to organise his back four, which was one of the strong points before today's game.
Yes, you mentioned hitting the post. Paul Marden with the header just before half-time, which would have made such a difference to Dennis Smith's half-time team talk. Goalkeeper was absolutely static, wasn't he?
I think the goalkeeper's there is on his prayer mat now. He's like, he knows he's totally wrong-footed, and he's watching it go helplessly into the corner. Lucky for Reading, it hit the post.
It's been a good first 45 minutes as far as Reading are concerned. Can Dennis Smith work his magic during the half-time interval? Those West Brom supporters don't look terribly happy. Christmas isn't going too well for them at the moment. But there's still 45 minutes for things to get better. We're back shortly. World Championship Boxing coming up on Saturday night over on Sky Sports 1, and another chance to catch Prince Nassim's American debut against Kevin Kelly. That's Saturday night from 9 o'clock over on Sky Sports 1. Half-time at Elm Park, Reading are in the box seat. They lead West Bromwich Albion by 2-0. Plenty of other early kickoffs up and down the country this Boxing Day. In the Premiership, Arsenal lead Leicester 1-0 at half-time. David Platt with the only goal of the game so far. It's Bolton 1, Barnsley 1. Georgi Christoph put Barnsley in front. Goodney Bergson equalised. Chelsea 1, Wimbledon 1. Gianluca Vialli early on for Chelsea. Michael Hughes with the equaliser for Wimbledon. Crystal Palace's poor home form continues. They're trailing Southampton by a goal to nil at the interval. Matt Oakley for the Saints. And West Ham 1, Coventry 0. Paul Kitson for the Hammers. Division 1, it's goalless at the Valley. Charlton against Norwich. Division 2, Bournemouth lead Gillingham by a goal to nil thanks to a Steve Jones strike. It's Brentford 1, Southend 0. Neville Southall in goal for Southend today, but he couldn't keep out a Robert Taylor effort. Bristol City 2, Millwall 0. Colin Cram and Rob Edwards for Bristol City, who can't put a foot wrong just at the moment. Second place for them going into today's fixtures. Wrexham 1, Wigan 1. Jorg Smeets for Wigan. Gareth Owen with the equaliser. And a latest score from Wickham where they kicked off at 1:30. It's 0-0 against the leaders Watford. And not a lot happening in Division 3 just at the moment, which is a bit of a surprise when you see that Barry Fry has taken his Peterborough side to Barnet, but it's goalless there and goalless also at Brighton, Cambridge and Torquay. 2-0 to Reading, half-time at Elm Park. It's back to Alan Brazil and Rob Hawthorne.
Well, when Ray Harford took over, the noticeable improvement in West Brom was in their defence, and he did it without changing the personnel too much. He did sign Alan Miller, and he did sign Andrew McDermott, who got the own goal as well, although McDermott really has had to wait until after Harford's departure to seize his opportunity in place of the injured Paul Holmes. But Smith himself was a no-nonsense defender in his playing days with Stoke City. Good long career there. In fact, his last appearance for them was against West Bromwich Albion. And yet two of his first three matches in charge of West Brom will be against Stoke. One in the league on Sunday and then the next one in the FA Cup. That's what lies ahead more immediately, is turning around the situation here. And the defence of which he is now in charge has been shown to be very frail so far.
Just give it another couple of seconds and they can't go off to a worse start than the first half. Dennis Smith will really be saying, come on, first 10 minutes, you know, we must pounce back. Let's get at them, put them under pressure immediately and get the ball wide, especially Coban. If you can get the ball in the box, you know, Reading sometimes, especially the opening of the first half, we're looking a little bit fragile, crosses coming in. I'm saying that both defences have been fragile from crosses, Rob.
We'll see if the wind has any bearing on it too. That's what Tom Harper will say as he airmails that one.
Can we blame the wind there or...?
Right over there.
It is windy and bobbly, there's no doubt about it. The players are having a problem passing, you know, three or four times in concession. But really, you know, West Brom have got to get the ball wide and get it in the box in the danger area. And the likes of Snakers and Hamilton have to keep making the runs into the box to support Hunt and Hughes.
Been doing the business so far, notably Williams, who's set up one goal and scored the other. This is Smith for West Brom, looking for Snakers or Hunt. And it's Lambert who's back there assisting the defence. Andy Hunt. Cross by Smith in towards Hughes, cleared by Bernal. Snakers took it down well, but Bernal giving him no room or time to line up the shot.
And there's a late challenge as well. Hughes has just caught the fullback, Swales. Swales, thankfully, up on his feet. Again, it's scrappy, isn't it? It's in the air. There's a challenge. That's a push from Hamilton. And the referee's blown. Again, referee had a good game, Andy Durso, catching out Ian Hamilton again.
Reading haven't won their last three Boxing Day fixtures, two draws and a defeat. Their last win on this date was back in 1991 at Bury. It was the year before when they last won a Boxing Day fixture here. Crouching duel there between Burgess and Morley.
That's what you call a tackle. And he got the ball. Morley quickly to his feet. Look at this. Bang. No complaints from Morley.
Yeah, no animosity. A handshake between the two at the end. Wales. Morley and Burgess again. Hodges. And away goes Asaba. Lambert joining Williams in the box if he can feed him. And it ran beyond Lambert. Williams trying to do the rescue job. Schnake has got there.
That was, you know, just when you're looking for West Brom to start well, it's Reading. chomping at the bit. Good ball from Asaba, cuts it back, spots Lambert, and really Lambert just takes his eye off the ball, James Lambert. That was a chance. Reading already 2-0 up, but starting the second half looking mean and hungry for more. As well as being defeated in four of their last five matches, West Brom haven't scored in those games either. Well, you get worried if you're a manager and your team are not scoring, but if you're not creating the chances, you think, right, we've got to change it. But Albion are creating chances. You know, we've seen four good chances from them today. Hamilton, who produced one of the excellent saves from Hammond in the first half. Snake has produced another, and then of course Marden's header hit the post. This is Hughes. Can't get it past Wales.
Yeah, we need an Albion goal, just alive in this matchup now.
Will it be Hughes who gets the side back in the match? Or Hunt. He's played well and all alone up there.
Thing that Reading fans want is a West Brom goal, because the nerves will start to set in. Davis clears, Schnakers comes in looking for the follow-up, and it was Davis who blocked it.
Good defending from Davis there. Winning the head and then knocking out the shot from Schnakers. Really, you wonder if it's going to be Albion's day.
Smith. Burgess. Dermot. Snake is offering the width down the right. It's been lacking since Flynn left. Cleared by Bernal. Saba and Morley the front two. Four Albion players back, but it was Hamilton coming back who made the challenge. And this is a player, remember, who's already been booked.
Yeah, he's got to be careful here, Hamilton. There's no doubt he gets the ball, but he just mistimes out. Saba gets his foot across and Hamilton's on his way. But that's a lunging challenge, but he does get the ball rather than the man.
Williams.
Just feel Smith's got to be across it for him. He's shown him too much respect. There's no challenges coming in from the fullback.
Williams has got it across. This is Asaba looking to turn.
Good first touch from Carlos Asaba. 2-0 up, thinks, right, I'll spin and hit this. Again, Williams a provider. There's the touch. Tries to get a bit of bend, going for that far left post. And he needed the ball to come back and be a little bit lower. Williams again, the provider.
Copan challenging well against Wales. And this is Andy Hunt with a clean run.
That's a good chance, Rob. 19 yards, 20 yards out on the left foot. And he just hits across the ball, which sends it away to the left. Gets a good strike on it. Keeper's beaten, but well wide from Andy Hunt. And really, are Albion going to take one of these chances?
Andy Hunt scored West Brom's winner when they beat Reading at the Hawthorns in September and went to the top of the table. Lost their next game at Queen's Park Rangers.
There's certainly no lack of commitment from Albion. Dennis Smith with a little bit tough talking at half-time, especially in defensive situations. But really, his side are creating chances, commitments there. And they're going to have a bit of luck and get themselves back in this match.
Well, it's very much a learning process, isn't it, for a manager, Dennis Smith. Experienced man grappling with a very different set of problems here to the ones he was faced with at Oxford in his dual role as a manager and director. But he led York to promotion. He was promoted twice in three seasons with Sunderland and gained the fourth promotion of his managerial career at the Manorground.
Dennis will realise this was never really an easy game here at Elm Park. And as a manager, taking over, you do want a bit of luck early on. So far in the match, has deserted him.
Reading's win, first win this season, came against
Smith's Oxford. And 2-1 back here in September. Sava, one of the scorers that day. Lee Hodges the other.
Sava's looked sharp, hasn't he? Making a step up from Brentford. There's no doubt of his ability, it was whether he could do it at a higher level. I'm sure Teddy Bullivant's delighted with him.
Hamilton aiming the ball towards Kevin Kilbane, who's switched to this right side to try and get more joy out of Swales. Hunt, Schnakers, Hughes all in the box. There's Hughes. Too short for Hamilton, cleared by Hodges. McDermott. Now Kilbane pressurising Swales.
Yeah, Kilbane switching wings, really coming in his left foot there. The service, the ball into the box should have been better. I'm not sure he was after, he was aiming for Hughes.
Hodges. Saba. Morley. Burgess there ahead of Carlos Saba, concedes the throwing.
Well, Burgess read it well, and Morley with a return pass here to Saba, well aware of Carlos Saba's pace. Doesn't even think twice about it. He knows Carlos Saba's got abundance of speed, but Burgess sticks his task well.
Cross from Swales. Hamilton. Hughes, who headed away Swales' cross in the first instance. Schnakers. He's looking to release Hughes.
It's quite incredible. Albion seem to have freedom of movement. You know, Hughes, you mentioned, Rob, back there earlier, heading the cross away, and then suddenly he's up in the left wing alongside Andy Hunt. So really, I think that, you know, Dennis has given them carte blanche. You know, if you have to go back and track and defend, fine. And Hunt alone up front, then the likes of Snakers and Hamilton can try and get up to him.
Hodges. Saba, because Burgess is there again. Now, if you're going to hit, if you're going to miss hit the pass, that's the area to miss hit it in, because the defender can't take chances.
Comes over, Saba's putting pressure on, conceding the throw in.
Butler. Spotted Hughes well. Now Smith has made a forward charge.
He's given good width on the left-hand side, Hughes. Just balance up, Kilbane on the right, Hughes on the left.
Smith. This is Martin. And Parkinson against Butler. We've seen so many duels between those two.
Yeah, the studs were shown a bit from either player there. Butler won't shirk a challenge. The ball just running away from him. There's the studs, and Parkinson gets there first, but takes a knock on the left knee.
Schnakers. Asala. Here's Morley. Lambert. Swales galloping forward to support him, but Lambert never afraid to go through. Swales obviously hadn't anticipated the pass. He thought Lambert was going to go all the way.
Well, I was hoping he was going to go all the way. Just like against Nottingham Forest. He's got quick feet, this fella. And here, he's got one defender left. He's got Marden, but decides to go wide. It's the first time we've really seen Lambert in full flow. It's great when you see people run at defenders. And suddenly he's to the last defender, but realises Swales is left, and a misplaced pass.
Lambert, the player who spent some time under Arsene Wenger in a week's trial at Monaco, looking for a Saba here. There's a push in the back of Martin by Carla Saba.
Yeah, he's shown his pace and his strength now, a Saba, isn't he? As Lambert is full of tricks. Good balance, quick feet, Asaba this time, you know, just maybe overusing the power. Getting his arm up there, battling away, certainly good strength, and Marden eventually goes flying, and the referee quick to spot it. Asaba boots the ball away, but no action taken.
Davis up for the free kick. Parkinson to Morley. Here's Hodges. Caught in the wind. Parkinson again. Davis.
Very congested in there, isn't it? When the ball's dropped, there's bodies, there's boots flying. Really, the game needs a bit of width.
There goes Davis.
Well, the fans liked it, but that sometimes happens when a centre-half tries to be a right-winger. No, the locals here at Elm Park have certainly taken to Davies. It's a good run, you know, he's pinning West Brom back. Just going for the corner here, trying to get the cross in. Yeah, and the goal kick.
But when you're 2-0 up, who cares about the cross?
Exactly, he's impressed me today. He has to keep an eye on Hunt. Hunt's still a threat.
Got a touch on there, and Schnakers and Hughes left it to each other, and Swales came in, but he's given it away. This is Hamilton. Ian Hamilton.
Yeah, Hamilton's been very, very busy. Hammond again behind the ball. Ian Hamilton picking up the loose ball. He had options. This is Schnakers and Hughes getting in a muddle. But Hamilton suddenly thinks, no, I'm 20 yards out, I'm hitting this. And just the ball's just behind him. And good positioning from Hammond.
Ian Hamilton scored at Port Vale in West Brom's only win in their previous five outings away from home.
West Brom desperate for a goal. I just feel they need something at this game to stop this rot.
Well, we're into the last third of the game. Dennis Smith's first in charge of West Brom.
It's a nice position Albion are in, but Sunderland are on a charge, Middlesbrough, Forest, Sheffield United, teams like City, Man City, Ipswich, they're beginning to get results together now, so West Brom have got to keep, you know, nicking things away from home. It's just lack of goals, Rob, that's the problem.
They need a run in the second half of the season to match the one that they've had in the first. So they need to stop giving away the sort of goals that they are at the moment.
Also, you look at Andy Hunt, pesky Solido going. If Hunt was to get injured or get suspended, you see, so where's the goals going to come from?
Marvin. Dermot. So a challenge by Lambert, but the throw goes West Brom's way. Swales. Noel under Miller's clearance.
Scrappy now. The Baggies have got to pick it up. They need a goal. Reading don't mind Kushner two goals. Help improve their league position.
The Reading rear guard at the moment doing its job, protecting Nicky Hammond. Here's McDermott's throw-in. Cross aim towards Hamilton. Back off Booty.
Booty's hand was very close to that as well. I think eventually it comes off his thigh. But in at the far post, Booty, and was it a right hand there? The West Brom fans didn't stop that. They're shouting for the back pass.
Corners putting Smith under pressure. Reading though defending well as a team,
Morley. Morley again trying to just ease it into Asaba. Very experienced Trevor Morley.
Here's Kilbat. Switch sides again to their original positions. McDermott, Hughes. McDermott again. Lambert. Burgess.
Again, Bernal not too far away from Andy Hunt. And really, is there going to be a change? Dennis Smith must feel the breakthrough hasn't come. It'll be time for a swap.
Smith. Here's Coban. Rodgers. Gradually picking up the pace again. Morley. Williams with his arm raised. Wanted it. Blocked though by McDermott. And it's offside.
Yeah, Morley this time, right foot. Looked indecision again. Miller was coming, then he stops. And Smith heads clear, but the flag was already up.
Now the anticipated change is about to happen for West Bromwich Albion, and they're taking off Peter Butler, the tiger of the midfield. And on in his place comes Mickey Evans, the former Plymouth man, signed from Southampton, but before he'd made his debut, fractured his cheekbone while away with the Republic of Ireland. West Brom compensated in financial terms, but it's been a slow road back for Evans. He's been used sparingly as a substitute since. He's got a touch there, and Hunt was through! Hammond blocked him, Evans! And here's Hughes keeping it in. Hunter's gone down in the penalty area and he appears to be in some trouble. In goes Hamilton. Williams. What an introduction that could have been for Evans. Just getting the touch on that put Hunt through.
Tell you what, Rob, it was a great stop again from the goalkeeper. Because I thought that was the goal that Albion needed to get back in the match. Hammond again, very alert. Anthony Hunt seems to be struggling a bit, but at least he's on his feet.
Asaba can't get past Burgess. Albion aren't putting the ball out. They clearly sense that Reading might be vulnerable here. Now Bernal has put the ball out and Hunt may get treatment if required.
Well, he's unlucky here, Hunt, isn't he? Evans with a good touch. Hammond's committed himself coming out in arrow, and that's a great stop. The collision was there. Hammond had no option. And Albion scrambling but can't get the ball in. Hughes this time trying to get it across. And the danger's gone. Good goalkeeping this. Makes his mind up. There's a touch. And that's a good stop with the right leg from Nicky Hammond. Hunt in agony.
Curse of the substitution in that as soon as you've made one, you pick up an unwanted injury. And Hunt in problems after Mickey Evans has just come on to take Peter Butler's place.
Yeah, maybe Evans is the man who can break the deadlock for Albion. Good player as Hunt has to go off, but he'll be straight back on. Very unlucky Andy Hunt, he's worked very hard. No joy in front of goal though. And that's down to Nicky Hammond in goal for Reading.
Well, while Hunt was being treated, there was treatment too for Gareth Davis, who got caught up in the melee.
I've had the chances, Albion.
A one-man light, although I don't think it will be for too long. Hunter's already raring to return. And they need him, really, in an attacking situation. And he's back on. Hamilton. Schnakers. Smith to Kilban. Four in a line waiting for Albion at the edge of the penalty area, but can they be furnished with a service? And there's danger if Reading can break. Hodges is threatened to do just that with Morley and Asaba up. Lambert. Here's Parkinson. Williams free to the right. He looks to the left though to Swales. Hodges. Lambert. Now he has found Williams. A cracking ball it was too from James Lambert. Some tricks from Williams. Morley. Parkinson. Possession really everything to Reading at the moment. Just over 20 minutes left.
Yeah, it was very patient, wasn't he? I think that some of the home fans were saying, get it forward quicker, but you're 2-0 up, and as you see, Rob, possession. If you've got the ball, then West Brom can't hit you.
And Parkinson has missed it, and Schneider's almost got there. It was just beyond his reach.
Well, I think the presence of Hammond here really, again, saves Reading at the back, because Schneider's, I'm sure, takes his eye off the ball. Hammond, again, very alert. It is a mistake, but Hammond's already on his way here, makes his mind up. And maybe Schneider's just seen the goalkeeper coming to take his eye off the ball. Good goalkeeping again for me. Just Parkinson makes the mistake. Schneider's on it very quickly with the right foot. A look at the goalkeeper's presence.
It was a collision with Hammond that saw Hunt being treated a few moments ago, but now it's Hammond himself getting treatment. And while he does, let me remind you of some of the football we've got coming up for you on Sky Sports. Premiership action this Boxing Day with Aston Villa against Tottenham Hotspur. That's from 4 o'clock on Sky Sports 1. And more Nationwide League action on Sunday from Bramall Lane. It's Sheffield United against Charlton. That's at 12 noon on Sky Sports 2.
That's a big one, Sheffield United, Charlton, both going well. Don't want to lose ground on Forest and Middlesbrough.
West Brom at the moment look as though they'll be losing some ground and losing another match. Just under 20 minutes to go there. Hammond all right again after treatment. He's been badly affected by injuries of late. Nicky Hammond only made one appearance in the whole of last season, and that was against West Brom because of a nagging back injury. Lost 3-2 that day at the Hawthorns, but at the moment his team in the driving seat and looking for a third. Marden tidying up against Asaba. Hamilton looking to release Hughes. Hammond had made his decision to come.
So what, this guy Hammond does well, patrolling his 18-yard line again. Any overhit passes, he pounces. Albion need a bit of luck or a bit of magic. Time running out now.
Swales. Schneekers. Kilbane. Hunt just holding off Andy Bernal. Smith it is who's made the run, and Hunt has freed him brilliantly. Kilbane! Smith. Schneekers. Hamilton.
Snakers was fouled, he's looking for the free kick, tried the 1-2 and was fouled. The referee Durso having none of it. Reading, plenty bodies back there, in behind the ball, making it difficult for Albion.
Well, the free kick given there for the challenge by Bernal on Hunt. I wonder if Evans feels an advantage could have been played.
Ricky Evans is disgusted here, and to be honest, I think the ref could have let this one go. Look at Evans, is right on and disgusted with the decision.
Free kick has been taken quickly. This is McDermott. Albion have loaded the penalty area. Hunt going for it.
You know, I can't help feeling Hunt deserves a goal. He has worked so hard, Andy Hunt. Again, getting in the end of McDermott's cross. McDermott does well. He hits the byline, clips it in. Again, Hunt in between two defenders. And that looked like a goal kick.
The corner has been given. Kilbane takes it. Burgess gets a touch to it, and Hamilton's battling, so too is Evans, and cleared desperately in the end by Trevor Morley.
Yeah, turning the heat up now. Albion, again, it's just flicked on, and they can't get a red shot on it. Hamilton done very well there, and Morley hooks away.
It's happening in front of the bank of their own fans, as Davis heads it into the crowd for another corner.
Surely this pressure, they must get one back at least.
Reading have to defend this near post flick on.
Can Reading continue to resist the onslaught? Cleared to McDermott. Kilban. And now a real threat to Albion. It's Lambert who's breaking. Williams tearing forward to the right, and it's not going to reach it. Burgess under pressure from Parkinson.
Lambert had a little chance there. Williams was the man he trying to pick out on the far side. Really, maybe Lambert should have just held on to it a little bit more. But that's the problem Albion have got. Intense pressure, need a bit of luck. But they have to be very wary of the counter. Although two down, Rob, time running out now. Less than 20 minutes remaining. They really have to take more and more chances.
Surely a third goal for Reading would finish it as a contest. They appear to be pushing the back of Morley there, but nothing given.
This could be a very important win for Reading.
Looks like being a substitution for Reading with Jason Bowen warming up ready for his debut.
He's a good player, Jason Bowen. I like him a lot.
Evans. Who's not been afraid to venture forward at certain moments in this match. Asaba has done well to hold on to it as Carl Asaba. Took the referee more in hope than expectation.
Trying to find Marley there, but it was a misplaced pass. Carl Asaba surrounded by red and blue jerseys. And really the challenge was after the ball had gone.
Well, substitution taking place while the referee is actually waiting to book Martin Williams, but the change is being made anyway. Lambert is off. Jason Bowen comes on for his debut, and the man whose position it appeared Bowen was going to threaten is actually having his name taken. Williams going in the book.
I think it was for back chatting to the referee over that Saba challenge. But Martin Williams, who had an excellent first half, maybe start to serve his second.
Bowen has been given a warm Elm Park welcome, but here's Hughes for West Brom!
Again, he can't get past Hammond. You see why Hughes gets goals. Very, very sharp indeed, but he's got to get past this man, Nicky Hammond. Good touch, and I tell you what, that's a good stop. He couldn't have seen that.
Bowen straight into the action. And again. To the rafters and picking out Williams. Crosses beyond the Asaba. Jason Burns had a frustrating time of it, stagnating in Birmingham's reserves while a move to Southampton broke down. Williams cleared by Marden. Hughes. This is Booty. Williams again. Kick. Here's Evans. Hunt has gone into the area. It's Kilban with a chance! And do West Brom have time on their side to turn it round yet? Kilban scores for the first time since the opening day of the season.
Well, I just felt it had to come. Intense pressure. Evans takes over here. Good run inside from Kilban. Skips across the first defender. Toe pokes it into the net. And being back in it. Evans with a good pass. Finds the run of Kilban. It's a great first touch, and that's a good finish. And suddenly Albion back in it. Evans to Kilban. Kilban just prods it past Hammond. 2-1.
And Kilban has had his problems winning over the supporters since his club record signing, but he scored one, and he could be through again, but it's blocked by Davis. There's Bernal. Reading now with plenty to think about, shaken out of any complacency that there might have been by that goal. Kilban the scorer. It's scored against Tranmere on the opening day of the campaign, having got up in the morning to find that the tyres on his car had been slashed, and now he scores in Dennis Smith's first game in charge and gives Albion hope yet of rescuing at least a point.
Yeah, there's 12 minutes left, plus a little bit of injury. Kevin Coban, big strong running winger, this time through the middle with a goal.
It's Booty's free kick. Morley's touch on, Davis is in there again, and there was a little bit of hesitation between Burgess and Miller.
Just indecision again, you're right. It's a lovely flick on from Morley. How many times do you see Trevor Morley do this? In the danger area, and Miller, well, keeps a good eye on it.
And here's Andy Hunt piling the pressure on Reading late on, and he's won the corner.
Yeah, the Baggies fans behind the goal, now they've got something to cheer about. As West Brom push for this equaliser. Now the smiles are on the big travelling support.
They haven't been smiling like this for much of the match since they went a goal down barely 30 seconds into the game. Bernal was injured in that last run of Hunt's, and that gives Reading one or two problems facing this corner, because he really has been a tower of strength for them. He's got there for the corner though.
The one thing West Brom do, they're on the corner, I know they get joy from, but they do love that near post. I think they've just got to change it now and again, swing one to the far post, because Reading, I've got plenty of numbers at the far of the near post now.
Dennis Smith sensing perhaps that this game may yet be saved and trying to organise his team so that that goal is achieved. Still 10 minutes to go. Reading need a goal to settle themselves. West Brom needing one to get nearer this fight back.
It's a little bit route one now from the Albion. Desperate they feel, the tails are up. Feel they can sneak something. There you go, West Brom possession. We've certainly had enough of it, had enough chances. Is there time left to salvage something?
Smith, and it's Hunt looking to get through. Swales with a clearance. Asaba. Williams just delayed too long, and that allowed Hughes to get back, but Smith is beaten off it by Williams.
Good play from Hughes. Breaking hard.
And Hughes here couldn't get it through Booty. And Parkinson, the Albion bench rose as one to appeal for the handball, but it wasn't given.
Well, I felt it was a handball from up here, because Snakers had made a great run through the middle.
Burgess, here's Hughes. Smith. Davis had to make the header, but here's Evans. Hughes, who's got through a lot of good work since he came on for West Brom, and he's got the cross in.
How many times has Bernal headed clear?
Hamilton, Kilban, Hunt going for it, flag up.
Yeah, Andy Bernal, so many times has had to cover the presence of Andy Hunt. This time heading at the air, and there's the offside decision. And a good one too, as Reading now make a change.
Yes, Carlos Saba is going off and on for the last 8 minutes of the match, comes Stuart Lavelle.
Well, I think for Reading's sake now, it's all about defending, isn't it? You try and hold on to the lead as West Brom gamble more and more.
Bernal. Here's Hughes. Evans. Burgess. A bit of pressure from Morley. Kilban.
Good play again from Hunt. And a disappointing ball from Kilban. Hunt and Bernal have had a cracking battle. And Kilban, well, he's got his side back in it with that toe poke. But again, the service, when needed, a bit of quality, it wasn't there. I share the impression that Albion are more keen to win the battles now as the game nears an end. Well, the 50-50s are going to Albion. Dennis Smith must be delighted with the commitment here. Not the defending first half, but the commitment, the fight back. And can it be complete with a second goal?
Curry Bullivant has had a little longer than Smith to get used to the team that he's working with. Had a wretched start to the season without a victory in their first six games. Since then, things have been picked up, but he must be learning one or two things about his side today. Can they hold on for the last 6 minutes? Andy Bernard. Cleared by Smith. Davis. Hamilton. Martin Guti.
Yeah, I've got to be so careful here because Snakers is almost playing the centre forward now. I've got Hughes to contend with. Hunt's always a threat, and Coban. Really, it's all about discipline now. No one going to sleep.
Here's Bowen. McDermott. Parkinson. Wales. And it's one for Morley to chase. Burgess, though, always had the edge. That'll do for Reading at the moment, but still 5 minutes to hold out.
Yeah, it's a hold-on job, isn't it? When you're down near the foot of the table and you're at home, you've got a two-goal advantage, it's a case of holding on, and suddenly you lose one late on. Begins to set in.
It was 2-2 between these teams here a year ago, remember? And Albion hoping, at the very least, for a repeat of that scoreline. Hamilton.
He's done well, Hamilton. He's battled away.
So too is Williams, who gave Reading that cracking start and then scored the second goal. Lovell and Morley ahead of him. This is Morley. Williams. Good play this from Reading. And Williams gets it across, and Bowen had the chance to mark his debut with a dream goal and couldn't get it on target.
Well, it'd have been an instant hero. Simple as that. Good interplay between Morley and Williams. Look at Bowen's run. Great run. Left foot and just wide. Good play. Patient play. And Bowen really from 11 yards. Goalkeeper stranded. That should have sewn the points up.
For the throw-in.
Just eases pressure as well off the Reading defence.
Breather then here for Bernal and Davis and Booty. But West Brom are hoping to make them think about things a little more again with a substitution, yet another one being planned. The only one that they have left to use now is Tony Dobson. Sure enough, he is going to enter the fray. Dobson coming on to take the place of Paul Marden. Fresh pair of legs for the battle in the final 3 minutes. Parkinson. Stuart Lovell a little high there on Darryl Burgess, so time for you to nominate your Boxing Day bonus champagne as man of the match.
Well, I thought it was a difficult one again. I thought Andy Burnell at the back was superb, winning the ball against a very, very lively Hunt. But I have to go Nicky Hammond. I think he's made crucial saves, first and second half, and he's my man of the match.
2 minutes for he and his defenders here to hold out against the West Brom revival. Evans, Kilban, who scored their goal, cleared by Stuart Lovell. Williams. Tony Dobson. Clearing header finds Jason Bowen. Real opportunity here to run at McDermott, and he's tormenting him. Lovely touch. Lovell. Bernard.
I tell you what, I think Neil Webb can pick my lottery numbers next week, Rob. I'm sure he said 2-1 to win something.
This Wales. Fat lady's not quite clearing her throat yet, though. Still time for another one. Bowen. Hodges, Parkinson, looking for Williams. West Brom being pressed back at a time when they need to break, not necessarily with style, but urgency.
And they battered away, they had so many chances, Albion. Eventually when they got the goal, just left them too much to do.
And Reading's stalling tactics doing the trick. A slow take of the throw-in, the time very much theirs to waste at present. Lovell. Williams, can he prize them open late on? Burgess in the way of Morley. Parkinson. Cleared by McDermott.
Yeah, it's not going too well for McDermott. It's tried hard after that OG. Didn't know much about it. Reading's first goal.
There between Bowen and Swales. Swales is in for a triple celebration today of victories achieved. Not only is it Christmas, but it's his birthday as well.
I think he's been the best fullback on the pitch.
Steve Swales, 24 today. Cleared by Bernal. Tense late moments these for Reading as West Brom look to break them open. Aimed towards Evans. And when Hammond needed to be commanding, Kilban's in there, but it's Hammond who takes the initiative and pounces. And Bullivant hugely relieved.
I thought when I see him go for this ball, I thought it was a kiss of death from Brazil, man of the match. Because he came a long way, but gets a second chance and pounces.
And he's lived up to his billing. Flying header from Bernardo is the other contender.
Yeah, he's had a smashing match.
Well into stoppage time. Is there still time for an Albion equaliser? It's McDermott's cross. Hammond judged it right.
Almost time up. There's a big smile from the goalkeeper and man of the match. But McDermott's really got to try and give a red shirt a chance, and that doesn't.
Snakers. Hamilton. Here's McDermott. This could well be the last throw of the dice for Albion. Hughes goes down. Throw in given. Ian Hamilton. Evans underneath it. Richard Snakers!
That could be the last chance, Rob. Snakers, who went so close first half. That's his sort of area. As the ball's knocked down, Evans does well, uses his body weight, maybe a hint of a push, but gets a knockdown. Snakers on the 18-yard line, just over. Can't quite keep it down, the ball bounces high on the knockdown, and surely the baggies' last chance.
Well, the referee has just checked his watch once already, and that's a challenge by Dobson on Williams that's punished with the award of a free kick.
Bounces up high. Dobbin, well, maybe looks a little bit worse than what it is.
Reading's prime objective to hold on to what they have, and Booty unsurprisingly hits it towards the corner. Here's Williams. Tempting Albion into the challenge. Hodges, Bowen, Schnaker's pressing hard along with McDermott. They're buzzing around busily. Lovell might have got through here.
Offside flag was up, but Miller was very quick off his line. He'll be disappointed to concede two, as the Reading manager has a frustrated look at the watch. Surely it's time up, ref, you see.
Well, the watch that counts is in the possession of Andy Durso, the referee. Is there a last chance here for Albion? Swales clears. Still no indication that the referee is to blow for full time. Hughes, though, trying desperately to get on with it. Another check on the watch from the referee. McDermott's cross, Kilman's header off the woodwork. Drama, 4 minutes into stoppage time, and Kilman, who scored one already, went so close there to a second.
Wow, what a good header from Kevin Kilman. It was a long searching cross the far post. Kilman comes across the defender, and so unlucky.
And in comes the corner, and that's Nicky Hammonds. Relief a moment ago, but he used his judgment to good effect there. And Reading hold on as Terry Bullivant celebrates a hard-earned victory. Defeat then for Dennis Smith in his first game in charge of Albion. But despite the negative of the result, I'm sure that for the new Albion manager, there'll be a lot of positive things to draw on. In many ways, you look on a result of this magnitude as a learning experience, and after the own goal from Andy McDermott, just 30 seconds into the game, there was a lot for Smith's team to do, and they responded well, even though they couldn't get the ultimate result. It really was the most shocking start for Smith's managerial career, when this ball was bundled into his own net by the Australian fullback, and things worsened when Williams, the provider of that goal, turned up to score a merited second. But the Albion fight back, which included two brilliant saves from Hammond and a first half header that hit the post, culminated in this second half effort from Kevin Kilman, his second of the season, and he went so close at the end with a header that hit the post. Reading, though, managed to hold on for this Boxing Day victory. Reading 2, West Bromwich Albion 1.
Terrific finish, and 5 defeats in 6 games now for West Bromwich Albion. Plenty for Dennis Smith to do. Well done, Reading. Now, still to come this Boxing Day on our 3 sports channels. Over on Sky Sports 1 at 4, we're off to Villa Park for Aston Villa against Spurs. That's followed at 7:30 by the Sports Centre Football Special. It's Test cricket here tonight at 6, and highlights of the first day's play in the first Test between Australia and South Africa. That's followed at 10 o'clock by a boxing special, the knockouts of 97. And over on Sky Sports 3 tonight at 10, wrestling action in WWF Raw. Well, Nicky Hammond was the man of the match at Elm Park, and he is now waiting to talk to Alan Bentley.
Nicky, if I can start with you, one or two hurry moments at the end. Did you have the header covered?
I think so, yeah. I feel a little bit sorry for them, really, because they played quite well, and we didn't really perform as well as we should have done. But fortunately, we got the points and we needed them, so we're very pleased.
Now, Terry Bullivant was praising you for your performance against Wolves. Another great game today. Is this the best form of your career, perhaps?
Well, yeah, I'm enjoying it. I don't know. I have to think about that. But it's nice to be back in the team. I've been out for a long time with a back injury, which was quite serious. So I just enjoy myself at the moment.
How is the back?
Fantastic, yeah. No problem at all.
And Martin, a good Christmas for you, setting one up and then scoring the second.
Yeah, I'm happy. I've got a good record on Sky. Scored 3-3, so I'm quite happy with that.
Now, how's the arrival of Jason Bowen put you and one or two others on your toes?
I'm just going to give it a bit of competition. We all need it in the squad. It's getting bigger, it's getting stronger. Hopefully we can just keep going, you know. It's good for everyone.
And you've played in a number of positions. Which is your best, you feel?
I don't mind where I play, as long as I play.
Well done. I'm afraid, though, Hughes won the Man of the Match, Nicky. You're on Nationwide Man of the Match. You can present it, Martin.
Cheers,
mate. Happy Christmas.
Happy.
Thanks.
I bet Nicky Hammond doesn't feel too sorry for West Brom. We'll see where that win leaves Reading in the First Division table a little bit later. Here are some other scores to give you. Full times in the Premiership. Arsenal have beaten Leicester 2-1, though Neil Lennon gave The Gunners are scared by pulling one back for Leicester 13 minutes from time. Bolton won, Barnsley won. Georgi Christoph put Barnsley in front. Gudni Bergsson equalised. Chelsea have dropped points at home to Wimbledon. 1-1. Viali put Chelsea in front. Michael Hughes equalised. Crystal Palace still haven't won at home, but at least they didn't lose. They were losing at one stage when Matt Oakley put the Saints in front. Neil Shipley got the equaliser. And West Ham have beaten Coventry thanks to a Paul Kitson goal at Upton Park. In Division 1, Charlton's good form continues. Don't forget, we see them live on Sunday at Sheffield United. Today they've beaten Norwich 2-1. Mark Kinsella and John Robinson for Charlton. Craig Bellamy from the penalty spot, 9 minutes from time. That, in fact, is still a latest score, so Norwich might just fight back. Sorry to write off their hopes too soon. Division 2, full-time, Bournemouth 4, Gillingham 0. Steve Jones with 2, Steve Robinson and Neil Young for Bournemouth. Brentford 1, Southend 1. Neville Southall making his debut for Southend. He conceded a goal to Robert Taylor in the first half, but Regis Corbould equalised for Southend. Bristol City continue their excellent run of form. A 4-1 victory for them against Millwall. Colin Cram, Rob Edwards, Brantinian and Sean Taylor for Bristol City. Carl Viet for Millwall. Again, that game is not over. Latest score there. Wrexham and Wigan is over. 2-2. Gareth Owen, Carl Connolly for Wrexham, Jorg Schmitz and Ian Guildford for Wigan. And Wickham against Watford has been going for about 27 minutes. Watford, the leaders, of course, 0-0. The latest score from there. And in Division 3, not a happy return to Underhill for Barry Fry. Peterborough have lost 2-0 to Barnet. Phil Simpson and Sean Devine with the goals. Latest score, not a good one for Brighton. They're 3 down at home to Colchester. Isaiah Rankin has scored 2 for them. Tony Adcock with the other. Cambridge have beaten Leighton Orient 1-0. Paul Wanless. And Torquay are now 2-0 up against Swansea. Latest score, Jason Roberts with the second. Kevin Hill had scored the first. 12:15 kickoff at Plainmoor. After the break, a more detailed reaction from Elm Park, where Dennis Smith's career as West Bromwich Albion's manager has begun with a defeat. And welcome back to Elm Park, where Reading have somehow held out for victory against West Bromwich Albion. The match facts prove that Albion had so many chances to get at least a point this afternoon. 16 attempts at goal to 6, 7 on target to 3 and 12 corners to 2. That goes a long way towards telling the story of the afternoon. 3 bookings, Martin Williams of the home side, Ian Hamilton and Peter Butler of West Brom. And the action areas, well, in the first 45 minutes, Albion did a lot more of the attacking and they dominated in terms of possession as they did throughout the 90 minutes. In the second half, try as they might, they couldn't break through and Reading actually came forward trying to catch Albion out on the break. They couldn't manage that either. Another full-time score to give you. In Division 1, Charlton have held on to beat Norwich 2-1. Mark Kinsella and John Robinson for Charlton. A Craig Bellamy penalty 9 minutes from time. Not enough for Norwich. So here's the table as a result of the two results already in from the First Division. Portsmouth down at the bottom. Crewe, Bury, Tranmere, Huddersfield, Manchester City in 19th place. They play against Crewe today. I'll have a word with Neil Webb about that in a moment. Port Vale, Oxford, Stoke in 16th. Ipswich 15th, Reading up to 14th for the time being at least, and Norwich top of the bottom. West Brom could have gone third on a temporary basis if they'd managed to win today. Instead, they've slipped to their fifth defeat in 6 games and they stay in fifth place. Neil, just a word about one or two of the fixtures this afternoon. The leaders, Middlesbrough, away to Huddersfield. That's a potentially interesting one because Huddersfield have found some good form recently, haven't they?
They've picked up very well. I mean, my old teammate Dave Phillips has joined them and he seems to be settling down the midfield, and a great result at West Brom last week, so Middlesbrough have to be on their toes for that.
Crewe against Manchester City. City fans hoping after the win against Middlesbrough that they've at last turned their season around.
Yeah, Man City are having a desperately strange season. They do well, like you say, they beat Middlesbrough, beat the top teams, but they struggle against the teams at the bottom of the table. So it could be another banana skin for Man City there. But, you know, Frank Clark, he got a win last week. He's hopefully got the confidence now.
And the one you'll have particular interest in, Nottingham Forest against Swindon, two of your former sides.
That's right. Swindon are at top six of the table. Forest hopefully could go back top of the table today, because I'd love to see him back in the Premier League.
Are Forest going up, do you think, this season?
I think so. I think looking at them performances this season, and Hoydonk scoring the goals, and Campbell, great partnership they've got up front now, and they're looking good.
Those matches to come, we've already seen Reading beat West Brom by 2-1. Let's have another look at some of the key moments. Swindon got off to a worse start as far as Dennis Smith was concerned. 32 seconds gone and his new team a goal behind.
That's right. I mean, you want your players to at least get the first 20 minutes out of the way without conceding a goal, but within 30 seconds they're up against it straight away. Just unfortunate, the keeper's brave, Morley's brave, and the fullback's just in the wrong position at the wrong time.
Morley getting stuck in it and trying to claim it, but it has officially been credited as an own goal, and I don't think he's got a big argument, has he?
No, you see, if you just look at his face there, he's a bit sheepishly saying that, you know, I didn't really touch it, but I'm going to claim it anyway. Typical centre-forward.
Well, West Brom created so many chances throughout the afternoon, but Nicky Hammond wasn't to be beaten, or at least not until late on, by which time it was too late. That was the first save from Ian Hamilton, and the second from Richard Schnake is even better.
Yeah, he kept Reading in the game without doubt in the first half, because after the goal went in, West Brom took the game to Reading and created so many chances, chance upon chance. But they were at the back, they looked a bit, you know, they were all over the place, and this is a tremendous cross from Lambert, and Williams left his marker completely, and it's just siphoned into the back of that, great finish.
As he said in his interview afterwards, he likes playing live on Sky, 3-3 games for him, and he anticipated that cross very well.
He did, yeah, he's the only one that made a movement forward in the back. The defenders don't like running back into their own goal, but I bet he's got a good video collection now, Martin Williams.
Albion continued to come forward. We couldn't quite believe that they hadn't got at least one back before half-time. There was the header right on the stroke of half-time from Marden, the goalkeeper completely stationary.
That's right. I think that summed up their afternoon, really. I mean, Marden's done everything right. He's put it straight back. Nicky Hammond's just, you know, praying it's going to hit something and go wide. And I think that just summed up the West Brom's day.
Mickey Evans came on in the second half. Lee Hughes had come on earlier, and they continued to bombard the Reading goal.
I think Nicky Hammond, well, he's obviously man of the match, but he was always on the edge of his box. He was always there, and he's making things difficult for. They've got one eye on him coming out, and he defended. He was the last defender, and he played exceptionally well today.
That was a nasty moment for him. Schnake is lunging in. Nothing malicious about the challenge. Hammond recovered, fortunately, from his point of view. Lee Hughes came on early. It was an interesting switch, wasn't it, to see Flynn go off and Hughes come on, and apparently Dennis Smith rates this guy.
Well, that's right. Interesting that he started with 11 players, and as soon as they go 2-0 down, he changed the personnel but not the system, so he was obviously not very happy with Flynn. But, I mean, there they have been Kilbine there. But that was a good finish. His first touch was excellent. It took it into his path, took him away from the defender coming in. He couldn't bring him down. And then just a little toe poke into the near post. Perhaps Nicky might be a bit upset with that going into the near post.
Kilbane's first goal since the opening day of the season. The £1 million player, the record signing. One or two points to prove to the West Brom supporters, but he had an influential final few minutes and he could have earned a point, as we'll see in a moment. There's Schnakers again, who has a habit of scoring when Albion alive. It was an anxious last few minutes. Terry Bullivant imitating Alex Ferguson by looking at his watch there. And then as we went well into stoppage time, Kilbane heads against the woodwork.
That's right. I saw Nicky Hammond interviewed there, and he said he felt sorry for him because he thought he played well. Well, it's a strange comment to make of the opposition when you've got a home win. But Kilbane there, I mean, that was basically the one at the end of the first half and that one at the end of the second half, both hitting woodwork, just summed West Brom's afternoon up. They just couldn't hit the target.
They're a battling side. We saw them draw 3-3 with Nottingham Forest live. There's something about Elm Park that gets them going when the cameras are there.
That's right. Yeah, they love it. It's a great little atmosphere at Elm Park, and it's going to be strange to see them playing at a new stadium next season.
Well, we can now talk to the Reading manager, Terry Bullivant. Afternoon, Terry.
Hello.
Merry Christmas. You must be very pleased indeed with that result.
I'm a lot happier now, yeah. It's a great result for us. We've got some hard games coming up. So that's, you know, crucial 3 points.
A worrying last few minutes, I imagine.
Yeah, where we got the time from, I'm not too sure. But you have to get on with that. But the one that hit the post, I didn't actually see, think was going in anyway. But the last 5 minutes was, I think the crowd was as anxious as us. And it was a very important 3 points to us. But as usual, every one of our luck gave 100%. We had a few injuries, but everyone comes in and does well. Andy Benali has only played one game. He's been out a month, yet he's he never even had a chance to have a practice match for love last week. And a lot of the lads, James Lambert, I brought off because he was ill. I asked him at half time how long he felt he could do. He said 15 minutes at the most. He'd done 25, which speaks volumes for him. And Gareth Davis was actually being ill in the half time now. I don't know whether that was illness or whatever they were doing over Christmas.
Have they been eating too much over Christmas, Terry?
I hope they was only eating, really, yeah.
What did you say to them before the start? Because you couldn't have had a better start. 32 seconds for the first goal.
Yeah, I said score one in the first 30 seconds and had one later.
They're very obedient then, aren't they?
Oh, they're good lads.
So what about the rest of the season, Terry? You've been up and down. We saw you produce that tremendous performance at home to Nottingham Forest. You've still got the Coca-Cola Cup to come as well. So an exciting 98 ahead?
We hope so. I mean, you know, it's good for everybody to get these 3 points because we've got such a busy programme coming up. We've got a difficult game at QPR 2 days' time. We then go to Cheltenham in the Cup, which is certainly not going to be easy. And then we've got the Middlesbrough game and then a game against Bury. So to get 3 points early is very, very... Well, absolutely delighted, to be honest with you.
Well, I hope you don't lose too many more players through illness in the next few days. Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
A happy Terry Bullivant. Reading up to 14th in the table, going well at the moment. After the break, we'll look back at those goals again and have a closer look at man of the match, Nicky Hammond's crucial contribution, which ensured a losing start for Dennis Smith at West Brom. It's been a happy Christmas for everybody connected with Reading Football Club. They have beaten West Bromwich Albion by 2-1 at Elm Park this afternoon. Neil Webb, who started his career at Reading, has been my guest today. Well, Terry Bullivant said he asked his team to score inside the first 30 seconds, and they did just that.
Well, I think every manager would love a team to score in the first 30 seconds, but he couldn't have hoped for a better start. I mean, even West Brom took the kick off as well and actually got it into Reading's midway into their own half.
Yes, it was a very quiet first 10 seconds at least, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. And then the Reading players, you know, just getting warmed up and think, oh, we'll take a throw in a minute, have a little dawdle around, and in about 10 seconds' time, it ends up in the back of the net.
Suddenly they remembered what the manager had said to them. They thought, oh, we'd better get down the other end of the field.
That's right. I mean, Asaba does where he holds it up. A little bit of a lucky break here from Morley, but goes straight into Williams' path. But after this, Williams does tremendously well. You know, takes his time, looks up, great crossing near post and puts pressure on, and you never know. 31 seconds, not bad at all, is it?
You've got to feel a little bit sorry for the defender, but he was standing there. There's nothing you could really do.
I mean, the goalkeeper was brave. He's come out, he's made the save, but he's just pushed it on, you know, straight onto his defender's knee. Defender's in the right place. There's nothing else he can do about that.
Williams was obviously full of confidence after his contribution there because he got the second. We've already mentioned that West Brom looked very hesitant when these teasing crosses came in.
It was a great cross from Lambert. I mean, he's got it there. He's whipped it in, you know, full of pace. And it's just our centre-forward likes that. Just a little tap in there. And that particular 2-0 up in the first half was a tremendous feat for Terry Bullivant.
It was incredible, really, that West Brom didn't get one back until the 77th minute. Kevin Kilban, their million-pound man, finally bringing them back into the game. But they'd had so many chances up until this point.
They were. We were saying in the studio that they've got to score sooner or later. And in the end, they've scored with a little toe-poke goal. And they've had all these other great shots that the keeper's saved or, you know, hit the post twice and all gone over. But nice little toe-poke into the near post. Like I say, the goalkeeper might be a bit upset, but then he's had an outstanding game for the rest of it.
Well, that gave the Albion supporters behind that goal hope. And deep into injury time, they thought they had a point to celebrate over Christmas. The deep cross to Kilban at the far post. Very, very close.
Just sums up their day completely. They hit the post in the last minute of the first half and hit the post in the last minute of the second half, and that's how it went. Like I say, they had 17 chances, 16 chances, 7 on target. You can't ask any more, Dennis Smith. They've created the chances. They just need somebody up front with a killer instinct to put the ball in the back of the net.
Well, let's see what he thinks, because he's waiting to talk to us now. Hello, Dennis.
Hi.
Are you disappointed with that?
Of course I am, yeah. I mean, I think that you've got to look at it, and to start after 30 seconds to be one down makes life very difficult. But I thought the lads created a great deal of chances and played some good stuff. But in the end, we've got to stick them away. It's no use playing well and losing. Prefer to play badly and win.
What was going through your mind after 32 seconds when you found your new team a goal down?
Can we kick off again and start again?
Referee wouldn't allow that, though, would he?
Unfortunately, well, we had another kick off, yeah. Unfortunately, it was after the goal.
You did have so many chances, and Neil's just said what you really seem to need is one player who can knock them away. Although Andy Hunt, to be fair to him, has got a pretty good goal-scoring record this season.
Yeah, Andy's, I thought Andy played quite well, and he's had a lot of chances today, which he would normally perhaps put one of them away. But if he keeps getting in there, I would expect him to score. And Kilblain has got one which gets him going a little bit, because apparently he gets quite a few chances as well. And we've got the young lad, Hughes, who played wide but can play down the middle, who's got a good score. goal scoring record. And Mickey Adams, who's been out injured since he arrived, he's there and he can score a few. So we've got a few, and we've got Bob Taylor, who wasn't even in the squad today. So we've got a few goal scorers. What we've got to do is not let goals in.
When Kilbam pulled that one back with 13 minutes to go, were you very confident that you were going to get a point out of the game?
Well, I knew we were going to get more chances. I was hoping that we would be able to put one of them away. Unfortunately, we weren't capable. Kevin was again unlucky at the end where he's at the post, but we've had a lot of chances. Richard Sneaks had a very good opportunity when the ball came there on the volley. You would expect him to hit the target.
Must just ask you about your decision to leave Oxford. Was it a very difficult one for you, Dennis?
Well, it's according to, are you talking emotionally or business-wise? Business-wise, I mean, the move to West Brom is ideal for me. Ambition-wise, they're a big club. They've got the same ambitions as me. They want to get into the Premier, and they've got the opportunity of getting there. But there were some lovely people at Oxford and some nice people to work with. So from that point of view, that is difficult. But I'm sure by the time I've been at West Brom for 4 or 5 years, then the people there I will get on with, and I'll get to grow to like them, and they'll get to grow to like me as well.
Well, it's 5 defeats in 6 games now for West Brom. How big a task is it going to be for you to install fresh confidence inside the team?
Having seen them today, I don't think it's a great deal of problems. I think that, you know, the lads were in good spirits. I've just had a good chat with them after, and we will get things organised. We're back in training tomorrow, and hopefully we'll start winning on Sunday when we take on my old club Stoke.
And is there money there for you to bring in some new players?
There is money available for me to go out, and once I've had a look at the squad, if I'm not happy with it, then we'll be out in the transfer market, yes.
All right, Dennis, thank you very much. Commiserations today, but here's to a happy 1998 for you.
Cheers, thanks very much.
Dennis Smith, who has begun his career as West Bromwich Albion manager with a defeat, thanks mainly to Nicky Hammond, who was man of the match for Reading this afternoon, and the goalkeeper earned his Boxing Day bonus with a string of great saves, Neil. That was the first of them from Ian Hamilton.
Well, that was the first. I mean, it was a great strike, but that's obviously give the goalkeeper confidence for the rest of the game, because he was domineering in his 18-yard box. He was always on the edge when Reading were pushed up, and he caused... Well, when you've got a goalkeeper in form like that, it's going to take a wonderful strike to beat him. But he was always out quickly. That's what I like. When it was over the top, he was always out quickly and putting pressure on the forwards, and they had in this instance here, they've got one eye on the goalkeeper coming out, and really Andy Hunt, who gets in them positions a lot, should have put that one away.
Yes, there was two or three occasions when he had to play the part of the sweeper, really, and you've got to be brave, and you can see Richard Schnaker's hairing in like that.
Yeah, goalkeepers are normally quite, what they call, they're called them mad, don't they? But
it helps, doesn't it?
It does help, yeah, especially when you've got to come out with Sneaks coming in that one. But Nicky was tremendous today, all round his performance. He made one mistake when he dropped across, but he made up for it by picking it up, and he had an outstanding game.
OK, well, let's just check on the other results this afternoon. Lots of early kickoffs up and down the country. In the Premiership, Arsenal 2, Leicester 1, David Platt and a Steve Walsh own goal for Arsenal. Neil Lennon pulled one back for Leicester 13 minutes from time, but it was too little too late. Bolton 1, Barnsley 1, Georgie Christoph put Barnsley in front. Gudni Bergsson equalised. Chelsea will be disappointed after a 1-1 draw at home to Wimbledon. Gianluca Vialli put Chelsea in front. Michael Hughes equalised. Palace 1, Southampton 1. Matt Oakley for the Saints. Neil Shipperley with the equaliser. And West Ham 1, Coventry 0 at Upton Park. Paul Kitson with the only goal there. The other result in Division 1, as we've already mentioned, Charlton 2, Norwich 1. Kinsella and Robinson for Charlton. A Bellamy penalty for Norwich. Division 2, good win for Bournemouth, 4-0 against Gillingham. Steve Jones with two of their goals. Brentford 1, Southend 1. Neville Southall making his debut for Southend. He couldn't keep out a strike from Robert Taylor, but Regis Colbolt earned a point for Alvin Martin's team. Bristol City still doing well, a 4-1 victory against Millwall. Cram, Edwards, Tinian and Taylor on target for City. Wrexham 2, Wigan 2, and a latest score from Adams Park is Wickham 0, the leaders Watford 0. And in Division 3, a disappointing return to Underhill for Barry Fry. Peterborough losing 2-0 at Barnet. Phil Simpson and Sean Devine with their goals. Latest score, Brighton 1, Colchester 3. Paul Emblem has given Brighton some hope, but two from Isaiah Rankin and another from Tony Adcock looks to have given Colchester all 3 points. Cambridge 1, Leighton Orient 0. Paul Wanless with the only goal there. And Torquay 2, Swansea 0. Hill and Roberts with the goals. A disappointing Boxing Day for West Brom supporters, but it's been a great year for football on Sky Sports, with the promise of much more to come.
Celtic. David Hopkins looking to come. Absolutely amazing. And it's 3-1. Shearer.
Last day miracle for Middlesbrough.
And Keane have got it. Zola. Gerrard.
England have qualified for the 1998 World Cup final.
Wallace taking it on. Here's the alley. What a goal! Absolutely fantastic.
Is there a team in the land good enough to stop them? To stop them? To stop them? To stop them?
Stirring stuff and so much more to look forward to. Neil Webb, thank you very much for your company this Boxing Day. Enjoy the rest of your Christmas period.
Cheers, Marcus. Thanks.
And don't forget, later this afternoon, more Premiership action. It's Aston Villa against Tottenham at Villa Park. Will Stan Collymore play? Find out 4 o'clock on Sky Sports 1. We'll see you at midday on Sunday for Sheffield United against Charlton. Until then, bye-bye.